So let's take a look at problem one. That is, what's the probability of getting the observation sequence given lambda, given an HMM? And so first I want to look at a naive solution, and then you'll see how the cool solution is so much better than the naive solution. So let's start off by pretending, assume for the moment, we actually know the sequence of states, okay? So that's Q sub 1 through Q sub cap T, right? Q sub 1 through Q sub cap T. That's the actual state at time 1 through time cap T. Each one of them is an S sub J, right? So maybe it goes from state 3 to 2 to 4, whatever. 1 through T is the time, okay? So we're going to assume that. And the other thing we're going to assume is that the observations only depend upon the state that you're in. So when we say independent observations, what we mean is that if you knew the state, then the probability of observation is just dependent on the state and not dependent upon anything else. Well, if that's the case, then the probability of the particular observation sequence given the state sequence, well, because of independence, it's just the probability multiplied times each other of the output of that of the particular symbol seen at time t, given that you're in the particular state at time t, and that taking the whole product, and that's just these b variables, right? So b of q1 that of O1 means the probability, given that I'm in q1, whatever q1 happens to be, of outputting O1, et cetera, okay? So if we knew the state sequence, then we could just multiply this to get the observation of the likelihood of the observation sequence given the state sequence. But for any given state sequence, I can tell you the probability of getting that state sequence, right? It's just a very simple product shown here, right? So if I know it's Q1 through Q cap T, then it's the probability, here's pi of Q1, of starting in that state. And then A of Q1, Q2 is the probability of going from that state Q1 to whatever the next state Q2 is, times AQ2, Q3, all the way up to AQT minus 1 to QT, all right? So assuming I knew the sequence, I could tell you the probability. Well, you say, in that case, I can do the following. Given that I can compute the probability of a sequence, of an observation sequence given a state sequence, and given that I can compute the probability of any given state sequence, well, then obviously we can compute the probability of getting that output sequence by just summing over all the different state sequences, right? Taking the probability of the state sequence times the probability of the observation given the state sequence summed, as I said, over all the state sequences, okay? You could just do that. Of course, the problem with doing that is it would take you a long time. How long? A really, really, really long time. And the reason is, this is summed over all possible paths, all possible state sequences, all right? Well, if there are n states and there are t time steps, that's n to the t, okay? Exponential in time, n to the t. And each one costs t calculations because I have to figure out the probability of O. So the complexity of that is t times n to the t. That, as we say, is a really long time. So it's not such a good solution. So you think we can do something better? Well, of course we could, or I wouldn't be standing here wasting your time.